The Korean show Squid Game went viral on Netflix. So many of my friends have watched it. They told me it's about people participating in children's game and competing for millions of dollars. They have to compete extremely because those who fail the game will be killed. I immediately felt it's an interesting show. I was like those VIPs. I wanted to watch that for fun and entertainment. Only I know the show isn't real. At first, I feel the show was not realistically plotted. How could the policeman sneak to the van, boat, and made it to island, even the frontman's office later on without being caught? In any horror movies, a guy who's so bold exploring always dies in the first 5 minutes. Still, I continue to watch just because it's so popular and I wanted to find out what the children's games are. The first game was horrifying. I liked the layout of the scene. It has bright colors on each side of the wall and looks fairytale-like and peaceful. It plays up the contrast of the massacre later on. It makes the bloody scene even more terrifying for audience and satisfying for perverts. But to be honest, if the show is just about killing, violence, human darkness, I would soon drop it. The storyline is actually very good. I can tell it surprised audience several times. On top of this, I think it's episode 6 that really got me hooked and touched my heart. Yep, I think it's a very touching show. In the last episode, the old man asked the main guy Gi-hun, "Do you still believe in humanity?" I feel that's also what most audiences question and we're curious to find out in this show. It's not hard to predict, it's going to be brutal in the condition where people have to compete to survive. People can betray and throw others under the bus. But if there's one person who can show compassion at the expense of his or her own life, it can prove humans are not evil. In episode 6, the girl who chose to lose the game to her partner showed the best quality in human. In that marble game, two players play against each other, which put them under the extreme condition. Is there only one choice left? Survival at all cost? Or is there more choice? The girl was an orphan and got to know her partner still have a brother and a mother. So she decided to lose the game and hope her partner can leave the place and reunion with her family. If you have heard about moral philosophy type, her action fits utilitarianism to maximize the amount of happiness. The girl said she has nothing to lose, but her partner still has a family. The action of saving her partner's life will maximize the group's welfare. It is absolutely very, very moral. At that moment, she considered for the group of two and make a decision to sacrifice herself. It's very heartbreaking to watch the girl get killed, and also it's why I think this show is great. It shows humanity in extreme condition where most people can hardly believe it. In episode 6, both main guy cheated on their partner to win. Gi-hun's high school friend Sang-woo even framed Ellie and killed him. If he has a moral standard, he could have let Ellie win, who is a dad, husband, brother, and also a son. Besides, Ellie already had the upper hand in the game. I don't know why women are often portrayed more kind than men. Maybe that is true. I also don't understand why the old man asked Gi-hun that question in the end, after he witnessed Ellie, the girl, and Gi-hun showing compassion and a good heart. Also, I don't understand why Gi-hun did not touch the money he won. Is the show trying to tell people that money will not change your life or make life of others better? Squid Game is absolutely a cruel game of killing people. But isn't the real life, the outside world, also a game? Both games are designed and operated by the same people. Rich, greedy, and powerful. Only in Squid Game, they want to watch people get killed and kill each other for competition. In real life, they want productivity and profitability, and they squeeze it out of people as much as possible. Also, I think our lives are slowly taken away by diseases caused by hardship, anxiety, and stress. The world has people working at cell phone factory. Do they really have to assemble hundreds of cell phones to get a meal? No, they can just hunt and eat like other living creatures in this world. but governments have taken every inch of land, monitored every corner of the world and people's mind. People are so deprived of survival skills, and they have to play the game alone. With that being said, I still don't think life should be dark. We can actually make it worth living. Everything is just a game. School, work, relationships. In playground, we learn the rule, play hard and enjoy it. We can have the same attitude for life. Find a job that you're interested in instead of suffering. Spend more time with people you care. Try to be a good team player, be passionate for life and respectful for others. People who are bullies or racist, they're just better players. Life is fun after I changed my perspective. Sometimes I imagine we could all just live like animals. We have enough resources to survive, much more than what rich people want us to think. But it's just my crazy thought. Well, I still have one question to ask the fans of the show. In episode 3, why did Sung-woo not tell Gi-hun anything about the game after he figured it out? What's in it for him to possibly lose a teammate? Does that just foreshadow this character will betray his friends whenever his personal interest is threatened? I'm just curious to know. Well, thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one.